Hello all, this is Ollia. Today we are going to learn about OSPF protocol, which is the open shortest path first protocol. OSPF protocol is an internal routing protocol. In an internal routing protocol, every routing information is shared only in an autonomous system. The autonomous system may contain different routers in it. So the whole routers is managed by a single administrator. So in an autonomous system, there is only a single administrator. The OSPF protocol is the most widely and the popular used internal routing protocol. OSPF is based on a link state routing. In a link state routing, a router shares its information to its neighbor. The neighbor then shares its routing information to all other neighbors. In this way, a single router shares its information to all other routers in an autonomous system, which is the link state routing. For handling the routing efficiently and in a timely manner, the OSPF divides an autonomous system into areas. As I have said you earlier, the autonomous system may contain different routers. So, in order to manage it efficiently, the OSPF divides the whole autonomous system into different areas. As you can see, there are different areas such as area 1, area 2, area 3, area 0. This whole autonomous system is divided into different areas so that it can be managed very efficiently and there will be less overhead. It uses Dijkstra's algorithm. The Dijkstra's algorithm is used to find the shortest path in order to reach the destination. It has unlimited hop count. The biggest advantage of OSPF with respect to RIP is that of unlimited hop count, because a RIP may only contain 15 hop count. After the 15 hop count, the RIP sends a message that it is unreachable. By the way, hop count is just the number of routers in a way to reach the destination. So, the OSPF protocol has a bigger advantage of having unlimited hop count. Metric of OSPF is count. Every router has a count associated with it. The count may be distance. So, using this count, the OSPF uses Dijkstra's algorithm to find the shortest path. Now, let's look at the operations performed in an OSPF. First, in order to discover the neighbors, the router first sends a hello packet. The hello packet is sent to neighboring router, the neighbors then respond to it. After discovering the neighbor, the router sends its database to its neighboring router. The database contains information such as cost. So, after the database is shared between all the neighbors, all the routers in an autonomous system knows about all other routers' information. So, using this information, it finds the best route and the shortest path to reach the destination. Thank you for watching, guys. If you like the video, please hit a like button and please do subscribe. Thank you.